Doctors and nurses continue to risk their lives as they try to help others recover from COVID-19. Now, in this process, some of them contract the virus themselves. Here is my interview with Dr. Mico Sollano, one of the health workers who got COVID-19 in the line of duty. Watch this. Hi, Mico. So how did it happen? When did you first learn about it? What symptoms did you experience? And how was that like?
Okay. So I was exposed to a patient who came in for generalized body weakness on the evening of March 6. I visited him just for 3 to 5 minutes explaining an ECG tracing. And thereafter, no more exposure. 2 days after, I had some colds with some chills. Immediately took some paracetamol and multivitamins, and that was gone the next day. However, I still had some itchy throat and a dry cough. And on that same day, that patient, we found out was positive. When we found out that was positive, since I had symptoms, I was immediately tested and then sent on home quarantine. 2 days after again, I was still feeling a bit, I had less of the cough and the itchy throat. But since I found out I was positive at that day, I was immediately admitted to the hospital and then isolated. During the hospital stay though, I had no more cough, no more itchy throat. But the peculiar thing was that I had no sense of taste nor smell at all. And I slowly regained that 4 to 5 days after. And that's wherein I became asymptomatic, or I had no more symptoms at that time. So I was already on the recovery and things were going better at that time. But those are very mild symptoms.
What happened? What was the first thing that went into your mind, Mico, when you found out that you tested positive?
So first thing I really thought of was I was going to cause a lot of stress. I was going to cause a huge depletion from the exposure aspect of me being a positive patient. There was a lot of guilt that came to me because I knew that I was creating a stress, not just me, but for so many people around me. And, you know, I knew that I would be fine. I knew statistically I would be a mild case, but things set in that when you're exposing other people, you're creating so much stress for other people that you feel guilty that you're not actually helping anyone to contribute to a positive outcome, but you're just basically putting a weight on their shoulders and not being able to do what they can.
Mico, how is the road to recovery?
So, road to recovery was more of a mental battle. As I said, I was very guilty with this entire thing that I was creating, but there was a lot of anxiety involved, especially when I was sent home from the hospital because you're anxious about the possible exposure that you can cause. Since I live with my mother, I'm so worried about her being exposed to my laundry, to my garbage, to whatever I touch, to whatever I have to bring out of the house or from my room. And you know, that takes a mental toll on me. And it was something that I had to, until now, I'm kind of paranoid about it because I don't want to expose anyone from this disease because it's a very, very, very fast one and can deteriorate patients in a matter of days.
Mico, when we talk about support system, how did you cope? And you said that you were kind of feeling guilty na may stigma, di ba? But at the same time, did you feel that also on the receiving end? How was the support that you received from your family and your friends?
So one thought also came into my head at that time was that I would have a stigma that I'm a positive patient and then people would be scared to even go near me. At that time, yes, I was isolated, but I was overwhelmed with the support that I got. My family, as soon as they found out I was positive, started calling me, getting updates, being there just outside the hospital, just staying, trying to take care of me, seeing that all my needs would be met. My friends would contact me every single day, asking how I was. My fellow doctors, even my seniors and even my consultants were checking up on me. And that was super overwhelming. And that support system was such a huge factor in me on a day-to-day basis because it kept me afloat. It kept me in a positive attitude. On times that I would be, you know, just looking out the window, thinking about myself, a lot of it had to do with prayer. And that really helped me, you know, just having absolutely nothing in control right now. It you know, you find some solace in prayer, in surrendering things to God. And it gave me a lot of peace of mind as well at that time.
Now, being in your field, Mico, of course, it's going beyond the call of duty. Right? And I'm sure that once you recover, what are your plans? I'm sure you want to get back on the front lines. Do you have any plans already of going back once you are cleared?
Yeah, immediately. All I'm waiting for right now, since I'm clinically stable already, are my negative results. I just need to make sure that those are negative because I am still a risk to other patients. Hence, I need to make sure that I am a negative patient. But at the end of the day, this is my calling. You know, I took an oath and no one has to force me in doing my duty as a doctor. This is something that goes beyond an individual. And if there's something I can do to help right now, I would immediately want to do that. It's something that gives me purpose. And if that doesn't motivate anyone to do their purpose in life, I don't know what will. So I'm itching to get back, but responsibly.
Yes. Lastly, Mico, for the benefit of our viewers watching now on ANC, can you give us some tips, some advice on the ones who are dealing with this, dealing with anxiety, some depression, or maybe the ones who have it, the ones who are positive, and the family members also, how to better take care of one another?
Okay. So for the patients that are diagnosed with this disease, I want you to remind yourselves that to appreciate the things that you have. Be grateful for whatever you have and still look for a positive in everything that's happening right now. If you can help yourself think of the positive things, it will go a long way. You have to see that you're fighting for something. Yes, you're fighting for your life, but after this, when you recover, you have so much more to give. And I want you to remind yourselves of that. Take this as an opportunity right now to do what you can. For everyone that's in this pandemic, especially the relatives of the patients, take this time as an opportunity to say what you want to say, do what you want to do, and make the most out of it. Right now, we know how precious life is, and we know how precious a circumstance is. It's changed so much lives right now, especially mentally. And we have to be smart with everything we do. We have to be educated. And once we educate ourselves, especially right now with this disease, we want to execute what we finally know about this. So why we want to avoid contact with anything, we want to have our hand hygiene being done regularly. We want to isolate ourselves if we think we are people under investigation or under monitoring. Be disciplined, sacrifice a bit. It will go a long way. And next, encourage other people to do the same as you're doing. Because to flatten the curve or to really combat this disease, it's really an effort among all of us. That's something we need to realize, that it's not just one person that has the responsibility. But everyone has a responsibility right now.
All right. So there you have it, Mico Sollano. Get well soon. Take care. Stay safe. God bless. And thank you so much for joining us here on ANC.
Thank you. Stay safe.